Hello and happy Black Breastfeeding Week. I am so excited to be here on my platform. I have been breastfeeding for 4 years now. Three of the four, actually. One of the, one August I was actually pregnant and didn't have my second son until September. So the last 3 of the 4 years, I have been in this space. This is the first time on the Pump with Purpose platform. So I am just so excited. I just appreciate all the love, all of this attention, all of the follows in this space. It is just so great. I mean, we have come a long way, but we still have such a long way to go. And I am just so excited to just come to you as a pumping advocate and just show that we are in this space as well. I'm doing a lot of collabs with some nursing pages, and I just thank you all for the welcome in this space. And so before I get to it, I just want to thank everyone, all of the pages out here helping us to bring awareness. I've been asked by so many, what can I do to help, to be an ally? And I just, you already are. The fact that you're reaching out, the fact that you're asking those type of questions, the fact that you're sharing our posts, sharing our stories, just being there to listen. I've had so many great conversations with just different pages I wouldn't have ever met, but just appreciate the fact that they are reaching out, wanting to know a little bit about us, wanting to know a little bit about pumping. I mean, it's great. I enjoy hearing the stories and just you to hear all about just where we've been and where we need to go to help bring this cause to the forefront is just greatly appreciated. There are so many generational traumas associated with this, and we just really want to bring awareness to our stories. And so before I get started to talk about the actual theme, the big pause, and what it means and how you all can take those, have those moments to rest. I just want to thank everyone out here for viewing, for all the other pages that, you know, I've been working with, collaborating with, and more to come. So I am just so excited to be in this space. Such a great welcome. And so just to talk a little bit about the big rest and how to do that. It is so hard, especially being a pumping person in the community. It's just very hard. I will be the first to say it. I've been doing it for so long, so I have found great ways to be effective at it, and some by choice and some by force, because we all know that if we don't get the rest we need, eventually our bodies will get it for us. And that is where I am this week. I'm not doing much resting because we have so much work to be done, but I do take a moment to rest when I can. And after this week, I will be surely resting. And so what I want to talk really briefly about today and how to take rest is the age old saying that I actually hate, but it is so true. And the form of sleep when the baby sleeps. So that is so hard to do. When I had my first son, sleep when the baby sleeps. What are you talking about? I have dishes to be done. I have to wash all these pump parts. I have to, you know, have laundry to get done, and I have to everything. It's just so much to do to actually sleep when the baby sleeps. I did not do that in my first pregnancy. After I had him both postpartum, did not happen. I was juggling, so frustrated, so overwhelmed with, oh my gosh, I got to do this. He sleep. Let me take the, you know, hour, 30 minutes, however long he's going to let me sleep. I mean, let me get this done to actually get some work done, do some housework, you know, wash the dishes, sweep the floor, clean the bathroom. I mean, it's just so much that had to be done. And I epically failed at it all in my first pregnancy. I was overwhelmed, overworked, and don't even mention when you go back to work. So that's another story that I will talk about during one of my big pauses to talk about rest this week. But for right now, it is all about sleep when the baby sleeps. So let's talk about my second journey. I slept every time the baby was. Every time my son would sleep, I would sleep. I didn't care if there were dishes in the sink. I didn't care if the floor needed to be washed, cleaned, scrubbed, bathroom. I slept to the point my husband would come home and say, "What did you do all day?" I slept. I learned the hard way. I learned trial by fire. I learned that I'm going to sleep. It will be done and still sitting there once I wake up. I learned ways to, while the baby's up, if he's playing, then I'll wash the dishes. I'll, you know, sit him beside me or put him in the swing or bouncer or, you know, something that works, or even the big thing, floor play. I mean, tummy time, taking that 10 to 15 minutes twice a day to get the tummy time in was when I, you can learn a lot of things and do it so quickly when you only have 10 to 15 minutes. I have learned that I can master so much in 10 to 15 minutes. I can get the dishes washed, start the dishwasher. I can throw a load of clothes in, let it wash, and be done. Now, laundry may sit there for a little bit, but the clothes are clean. If I'm cleaning out, if I'm dressing out of the clean clothes, then hey, I mean, I slept. I enjoyed myself. I mean, of course, my oldest son, you know, I had him in daycare. We kept him there. So I enjoyed both of my maternity leaves with each kid. We put him in there to keep him on his schedule. So it was just me and my youngest, and I had a great time. I was sleeping, I was eating, we just had a blast. And it was a complete difference in me, my mental health, my state of being. And I cannot say enough that sleeping when the baby sleeps is hard to do, but if you tell yourself, and I'm going to talk about different tips to how to get things done quickly throughout this week, or how to rest, or, you know, but I think for today, the biggest thing I want to say is, you know, doing things while the baby is up, while you're both, you know, active and have gotten the rest, you can get a lot more done faster by getting the sleep that is appropriate. So I just cannot express to you enough the importance of getting rest, the importance of taking the time to sleep, to rest, to eat like you should, to drink enough water, stay hydrated, not just, you know, for lactating, but also just in general to have a healthy mind, body, and spirit. I am just a big advocate for sleeping. And throughout the week, I will talk about different ways to rest, to effectively get things done that work well for me, and just hope that you all grab a little snippet from it, take a little bit with you on this journey. And I am just so happy to talk to you all about something that we don't do enough of. So until next time with Pump with Purpose.